Hello! Today we are looking at the Nikon D5100. It came out almost 5 years ago, but with a few tweaks, it still competes with cameras of today. If you're looking for an inexpensive camera as your first SLR or a second camera on the shoot, this is a great option at around $200. I'll compare it to my current camera, the Blackmagic Pocket Camera, to show you just how good an image this thing can create. Let's go! First off, a few specs. The Nikon has a 16.1 megapixel CMOS sensor and shoots 14-bit RAW files. It has a native ISO range up to 64,000, an expandable range up to 25,600, and expandable even further up to 102,400 in Nikon's night vision mode. For the movie makers out there, the Nikon shoots 1080p video at 24, 25, and 30 frames per second at a bitrate of 18 megabits per second. But here's where it gets interesting. Thanks to the people at Nikon Hacker, with a simple firmware update, you can greatly increase the functionality of this camera. You can unlock bitrate outputs of 29, 36, 54, or even 64 megabits per second for up to 3.5 times the original data rate. Uncompress or lossless compress RAW files, and if for some reason you don't shoot RAW, you can even increase the quality of your JPEGs. You can unlock the invaluable function of view and change exposure in live view, remove time-based restrictions on recordings, and only be limited by file size now. Now here's some Nikon footage next to some Blackmagic footage. This is mainly to show how the Nikon performs next to a dedicated video camera. I shot on the Blackmagic camera in film mode, and on the Nikon on a modified version of a custom color profile called Milk. Yes, I said Milk. This profile lets you capture a larger dynamic range and more detail in your shots. It creates an image much closer to the Blackmagic's than the basic in-camera color adjustment can accomplish. Now I almost forgot. You might be asking, what about photos? Yes, unlike the Blackmagic camera, the Nikon does take stills. The quality of the lossless RAW files massively outperforms its now $200 price tag, and paired with a decent lens, it really makes for a winning combination. Here are a few photos to show for it. This camera has been great for me. Everything that I've shot before this year has been on this camera. The extra features really do make it much more usable and great for anyone looking to get creative on a budget. There are options on the Canon side, but this is what I know. What's the best budget option for you? Let me know in the comments. I'll leave all relevant links in the description, and thanks for watching.